Bits and pieces are all we may know about the music of Antonín Dvořák. Pieces like the one we just heard, a lively and vigorous Slavonic dance for full orchestra. Almost carousel-like in its swirling phrases, tinkly percussion, and catchy repetitive motifs. As for titbits of information, it is well known that Dvořák lived during the 19th century, that he composed a standout symphony subtitled From the New World, and that he was born and raised far from that world in Bohemia, nowadays part of the Czech Republic. Indeed, this last point about the composer's national identity has tended to colour most accounts of Dvořák, his life and career, within biographies and history books, not to mention CD sleeves, programme notes, and critics' reviews. Time and time again, we are told of the composer's lowly status and unsophisticated social background, of his deeply felt love for his homeland and his voracious appetite for native traditions. This is not to mention his rich and resonant music, a vehicle, it seems, for the expression of a pure and timeless folk culture. Like other so-called nationalist composers of the 19th century, Bedřich Smetana, Franz Liszt, Piotr Tchaikovsky, Dvořák sought to celebrate and showcase the distinctive features of his native music, its characteristic rhythms, melodies, and even its musical scales, sequences of pitches. His compositional process, we are told, was perfectly natural, utterly instinctive and spontaneous. According to the Czech writer Josef Zubatý, Dvořák identified his whole personality, without reserve, with his art, so that you will find nowhere a greater sincerity of artistic expression. Reflecting on Dvořák and his achievements, fellow Czech composer Leoš Janáček made a similar acknowledgement. In him, his person and his work were interchangeable. There is more we could say here about Dvořák and his inherently personal music, its lofty simplicity and spiritual nobility, but also its perennial unfading freshness, its easy fluency and ultimate good cheer. As for the reception of this music, critics both past and present have shared an intense enthusiasm, even an entrancement. Janáček admitted that for him, Dvořák's melodies were as if he had taken them from my heart. Czech musicologist Josef Bohumil Förster also confessed to a kind of psychological or emotional kinship. Förster, it seems, was not only captivated, but carried away by the composer's creative flight. I yield myself up completely and willingly to the intoxicating sound. When listening to his works, I lose all power of criticism and become a mere listener, with nerves tingling to their very tips in sympathy, singing, weeping, rejoicing, and dreaming along with him. This short life history aims to wrest back some of that power of criticism, to pause for a moment and ponder anew both Dvořák the man and his music, the conditions of its creation and performance, and its reception by critics on both sides of the Atlantic. We will want to keep firmly in mind the standard wisdom just recounted about Dvořák's national heritage, his compositional aims and methods, and the quirks of his creative personality. This is to say nothing of the commonly held views on Dvořák's works, supposedly imbued with the spirit of Bohemia, its picturesque folk culture, and enduring traditions. A fresh perspective might reveal new insights, new bits and pieces about the composer, but it might also challenge what we know, or what we think we know, about a life, a career, and a repertoire in which, according to one recent reviewer, there isn't a single dull note or dead spot.